Hey, church family, it's me again, Annie Neufeld, your small groups pastor here at Lake Avenue Church. This past weekend, I got to preach in our Christmas series, our Advent series called Unwrapped, and I got to preach from Isaiah 12, verses 2 through 6. And in this passage, Isaiah is rejoicing. He is prophesying about a coming day when Israel would be set free. In chapters 1 through 12, Isaiah has been prophesying that Israel, not Judah, as I said in my sermon yesterday, I'm so sorry for that confusion, but that Israel will one day be conquered by Assyria, by the empire of Assyria, and that they would be dragged into exile, but then that one day they would be set free. Assyria would be defeated, and the people of God would be rescued and delivered. Isaiah says, with joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation, that God is our source of joy. When we spend time with God, when we spend time in prayer, in God's word, when we spend time with our community of faith, vulnerable and real, we are filled with joy. With joy we draw water from the wells of salvation. But often, church family, we don't drink from the wells of God's living water. We drink from other wells, bitter wells. We drink in the bitter water of jealousy and contempt and pride. We take in what our social media feeds say, what our news media says, and we end up being embittered people. But luckily, that's not the end of the story. Our Lord Jesus Christ died on a cross to set us free, and so we do not have to drink that bitter water anymore. God has said, there is room here for you at my table. Come, be part of my family. We too have been set free. So the questions that I want to invite you to mull over and to talk about this week are some of the same from the sermon. First, what are the bitter wells that you are drinking from in your own life? What is shaping you and molding how you think about the world around you that might not be honoring to God and to the people who are made in God's image? Take a moment to answer that honestly in your group. And then second, what are some of the wells of salvation around you that God is inviting you to drink from more regularly? How can you reorient your life around these wells of living water? Well, church family, as we move into the coming weeks of Advent, as we keep marching towards Christmas, hear these words again from 1 Peter 1, verses 8 and 9. Though you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you don't see him now, you believe in him and you are filled with an inexpressible and glorious joy. For you are receiving the end result of your faith, the salvation of your souls. May we celebrate our inexpressible and glorious joy this Advent as we await the coming King. Go in peace.